everyone. So I've been doing a lot of organization in the last couple of days. I've been going through my apartment and picking tiny little spaces and spending a lot of time perfecting that small space. So it's tiny little areas that often get overlooked when you're trying to do like an organizational project, because it's those little spaces in your house that get the most cluttered. So there are things like a certain shelf on my bookcase or my medicine cabinet or my top bathroom drawer. So I'm just gonna take you guys with me and show you a couple of the small spaces that I've organized recently and how I got them to function and look as beautiful as possible. So yeah, I'm gonna show you my first space now. The first area that I wanna show you is my scarf collection. And I used to keep these in a box, but I'm a little bit of an out of sight, out of mind person. So having them in a box tucked away didn't really work for me because I would just forget about them. So I decided to pull them out and hang them above where I keep my shorts, which is above where I have my jeans. And I showed this organization in another video that I'll link below if you wanna go watch that. But I thought that this was also a nicer way to keep the scarves in really good condition because they're not crinkled up, thrown in a box somewhere. They're actually hung really nicely the way they would be in a store. So I double hung my scarves. I have in the front my spring and summer lighter scarves that are a little bit more shimmery. And then in the back, I have my heavier woolen, winter, more neutral scarves. So because the scarves are so short, they hang really well above my shorts. I wasn't really using this area of my closet because when I hung clothes on these bars, it would just hang too long and end up kind of covering these shorts. I thought that having my scarves here that are much shorter would just be a nicer, you know, organizational system. And I also like being able to see all of my scarves because they're really bright and pretty, and it just kind of gives a really put together look to my closet. The way I've hung these is I've folded my scarf in half and then I folded it in half again. And then I've just tucked the loop over the bar and then pulled the length of the scarf through the loop. So it's really simple. I would show you right now, but I can't really show you while holding my camera. You can like hang it any way you want. That's just the way I did it. I think it looks really nice and neat. And I kind of have it a little bit going in color order in the front here. And like I said, my more neutral ones are in the back. So the front is my spring and summer ones, and I will probably alternate this when the fall and winter comes to have those scarves be in the front. But I'm going to go ahead and take this first bar down to show you what my scarves in the back look like. This is what the bar in the back looks like with my fall and winter scarves. I just took the bar down and placed it right there for now, just so I could show you what the back looks like. And like I said, I just double hung the bars and I put this one a little bit further down than the one in the back. You can see them both when you're just looking in my closet. So I think overall, not only does this look really nice, but it also keeps my scarves out where I can see them and wear them more often, and also in better condition because they're hanging nicely instead of stuffed into a box. The second area I want to show you is the inside of my medicine cabinet. Now, my apartment actually came with this built-in medicine cabinet, and I didn't like it at all at first because I just thought that it was like, I just didn't really like the way it looked. I would have rather my apartment not even come with it. But it started to actually be really useful for me because I don't like to have any clutter on my actual bathroom sink. And this is all the stuff that I use regularly. So I either use this every morning, every night, or at least I use it often enough that I feel like I'd rather have it right here at my fingertips instead of put away underneath my bathroom sink. So I'm just gonna run through and show you what I have in here. I have two body creams from Lush. And then I have two body butters in their little tins up there. And these are the products that I'm currently using. I do have a few other body products that are in my vanity, but these are the products that I'm currently using up. So I also have an ocean salt and a mask of Magna Menti from Lush and a Pavonia face mask. So I have my two masks together and my two like body creams together. And then I have my exfoliator with my mask. So I kind of have everything organized by type in my medicine cabinet, and this medicine cabinet actually has adjustable shelves, which is really nice. And again, like I said, it just came with it. So if you have a medicine cabinet and you're not really sure what to do with it, I would recommend using it for kind of your everyday products. And then I have my Pavonia Timeless Repair Serum and my eye contour. So those are both the Meoxy Caviar line, and they're just like different treatments. And then I have my Kate Somerville Dark Circle Corrector, which I love, and my new DDF Bio Moisture Eye Serum, which I'm not really sure if that one's that great yet. I've only used it for a couple of weeks now, and I haven't really noticed a huge difference. So I don't know, we'll see. Then I have my La Mer Moisturizing Cream and my Bobbi Brown Eye Cream. Underneath that, I have my Mario Badescu Drying Lotion, which is my spot treatment. My Philosophy Booster C Powder, which is a vitamin C powder that you can mix in with your moisturizer. And my Lush Sweet Lips, which is a lip exfoliator. And then at the bottom, I have my mouthwash, my Pavonia toner, my eye makeup remover by Sonia Kashuk, my Refresh Liquid Gel Eye Drops, and my Retinol Eye Cream, which I've been using at night. And my cleanser is normally in here as well, but it's actually in my shower currently. And then on the inside of the door, I have this cute little sign that I made that says, "You don't have to brush all your teeth, just the ones you want to keep," with my cute little hand-drawn toothbrush there. I just think this quote is so funny. It makes me laugh every single time I read it. I don't know, it's just kind of one of those like silly little quotes that perks me up every single morning when I see it. I just think it's really silly, so yeah. I did want to originally put like a bunch of motivational quotes on the inside of this, but this one just sums up everything so well. I just think it's so funny. And the last small area for this video is going to be underneath my bathroom sink. As you can see, I have two under sink cabinets. This one has my beauty products and the other one has cleaning supplies and pine cone supplies. So his extra food, extra litter, grooming supplies, treats, all of that stuff goes under there. So I'll probably show that eventually, maybe in a bathroom tour video, but for now, this is the one that is kind of organized, so, or that has any sort of organizational structure, because the other one just kind of is like bigger, bulkier items that are just kind of in there. The first organizational container I have in here is this double-tiered white mesh drawer that's from the Container Store. And on the top drawer, I have all of my tanning supplies. So my Saint Tropez and my Gradual Build-A-Tan. And then in the back, I have some hair supplies, just kind of some extra beauty products. And I thought that this double-layered drawer thing would work really well because I would be able to stack multiple tall products instead of just doing it on the bottom and then losing all of this vertical space. So in order to get it as close to the top of the bathroom cabinet as possible in order to maximize the space, I thought this was great. I'll link this actual exact drawer below. And then in the front here, this is just a box that something came in, some beauty supply item, and I just cut the flaps off the top, like, you know, where they fold in, and I used it as my toothbrush storage because I'm a little bit weird. I always have a lot of toothbrushes at any given time because I like to change them out often. So I have all of my different toothbrushes here just kind of stored upright, and then also two extra candle lighters here in the back. Just these kinds that normally come in multi-packs just because I go through those fairly quickly. So I like having a couple extra. And then I have my teeth whitening underneath. This is a roundabout thing that's also from the Container Store that I'll link below. And it's small, but it holds all of my more regularly used products. So I have like my nail polish remover, I have some Pavonia products and eye cream, different hair products. These are things that I use more often than the things that are in this drawer. So they're right here in the front and they're very easy for me to access. In the back, I have just a little like storage bin that has all of my extra hair tools. So my extra curling irons and hair brushes and all of that that I don't really use ever at all. So they're back there where I can't get to them as easily, but if I ever need them, they're there. And then on the top, I have extra cotton pads and extra Q-tips, and ignore the ugly bathroom pipe. No under sink bathroom pipe is ever attractive, and I cannot figure out how to make that look any cuter than it does right now. It's really ugly, but anyway. And in the front here, I have four little black boxes. The top two are actually Beauty Army boxes, and then the bottom two are just black boxes that I had that kind of fit the space. I think eventually I'm going to switch them all out to all be these Beauty Army boxes, the more Beauty Army boxes that I get in, because they are perfect for organizing. So I have them kind of color coordinated with felt pouches, samples, deluxe samples, and perfume samples. So this holds all of my beauty products that I get in my Birch boxes and my Beauty Army boxes. And I like that they go in rainbow order. And when I get a few more Beauty Army boxes, I'm going to add a blue one and a purple one. And so it will be a little bit taller and therefore, you know, store more stuff. And on the top, I just have my little cleaning wipes, makeup removers. And these are the double sticky post-it notes that actually have sticky all the way across. So instead of just being sticky, you know, right on the end, they're sticky all the way across and they're removable really easily. So I really like those. So that's what that is. And that is my under sink storage, and that is everything. If you like this type of small space organizational video, I can do a second video showing you three more spaces, so just let me know in the comments below. So I hope you guys enjoyed seeing some of the spaces that I've recently organized, and if you have any requests for future organizational videos, leave your comments below, and I'll see you guys next time.